Welcome to our special look back on the recent Ashes.
The mission was to be the best team in the world. We failed. There is a huge gulf between the best team in the world and the second best team in the world. They did make the mistake, and people have to pay for their mistake. Well, they've got to play more meaningful cricket before a tour starts, not going back home to spend time with their families. The fact was, in, 10 innings in the series, England collapsed woefully on 7 occasions. The opening partnership didn't produce anything. I really do think that players are now too mollycoddled. They now swan around 5-star hotels. They're treated like pop stars. Have Vaughan playing in that match against Western Australia is a total nonsense. What the England guys have got to remember is that they were lucky to win the 2005 series. The bowling is a complete shambles. Can't underline enough the hole that Simon Jones left in that 11. Nobody managed to get the best out of Palmerston, least of all himself. Look at Harmison's record over the last 2 years. He hasn't done anything for England at all. 10 wickets in a 5-match test series. You're joking. If he wants to retire from one day cricket, he may as well retire as test cricket as well. He wants to play for Durham. Go ahead and play for Durham. If you don't want to leave Ashington, stay at home. The England bowling was dreadful. What did Ashley Giles' action look like? He didn't look the same bowler at all. He was bowling slow left-arm lobs, non-spinning lobs. Duncan Fletcher, he likes Geraint Jones, he likes Ashley Giles. The situation's been an autocracy under Duncan Fletcher. He's been a dictator who's done everything his way. Sounding more like George Bush and Tony Blair every day. Excuse makers incorporated.
Sounding like grumpy old men.